Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to thank you for coming. We're beginning a new school year here in Orangeburg and surrounding area. We've already had some half days of school. Next week will be our first full week of school. So what we're attempting to do is have an education and enforcement campaign that's directed toward school zone safety. There will be a heavy enforcement effort in those areas. We take speeding and school zone safety very seriously. We have a lot of children in the area. Some of those children walk to school. Some of the highways that they're on are busy highways and side streets. Do have a good bit of traffic. And we're trying to do everything we can to ensure the safety of these kids and minimize the risk. Now, we do want to tell folks this. The last thing that we want to do is be punitive. We do not want to write a person a ticket unless we absolutely have to. But there's really not a whole lot of room for compromise as it pertains to speeding in a school zone. You're either speeding or you're not. If you're speeding, you're placing the lives of these children in jeopardy. And that's not something that we can tolerate or that we will tolerate. So we ask, we implore the public to please slow down in these school zones. Pay attention to the children as they come to and from school. Pay attention to the school buses that are picking up kids in the morning and dropping kids off at night. Be mindful of where you are. Be mindful of what your speed is, and be mindful of your surroundings.
Got it. Good evening. Thanks to new legislation, for also changes regarding school zone and passing school buses. We no longer have to be present for a citation to be issued for the stop arm violation. Thanks to technology and video camera on the school bus, forms will be filled out and information sent to the Department of Public Safety, and citations will be issued by way of jurisdiction where the violation occurred. Just want to reemphasize some facts. Passing a school bus on a two-lane roadway, motorists traveling in both directions must stop. A four-lane or more road, motorists approaching a school bus from the opposite direction do not have to stop. However, motorists behind the school bus do have to stop. Fines, which is a key element here. The minimum fine for first offense starts at $500 plus court costs and can go either upwards of over $1,000. Second offense violation, the fine can be $2,000 plus court costs. Just want to make one reference. The primary goal of this unified group is to consistently look at the way to improve roadway, especially school zone safety. However, the public can do its part in assisting us with this very important task. Please follow and obey all traffic and safety rules in the school zone. And remember, a school zone is only as safe as the drivers that are in there. Thank you.